Hi, hi, we're back again. We're back for part
I'm Rebekah.
Two.
I play Terese Willis.
Yeah, and I'm not.
Who are you?
I'm Stefan. And I play Paul.
Okay, you've got the first question.
I'm going to go first because it's very important what Hannah's asking. She says, what has been your fave Paul and Terese moment so far? Yeah, go on, throw that one at you.
The scenes that we kiss. I don't know. I like all our scenes together. I know, we love each other so much. I don't know. I think when we're at that...
It's one of the most difficult questions you can have thrown at you. What's your favourite moment that you've had in the show? What's your favourite scene that's in here?
Oh, every scene that we do is so great. But probably when we're at Loggerheads, that's when it's fun.
Yeah.
And our erst scenes, when it's written in the script where we have this moment.
Yeah.
They're fun.
There was,
Because Stefan gets his little erst eyes on. His, like, lovey-dovey, his lovey-dovey puppy dog eyes. Okay, Stefan.
No, I agree with you. I think when we're sort of argy-bargy, that's the most fun.
Absolutely.
Actors are strange people, aren't they? You know, we think argy-bargy at each other's throat is fun.
Anyway, you're strange.
You are.
So, Stefan. You have had the original Scott Robinson appear a few years back, and you've had Des appear, and now Clive. Who else from those first years would you like to come back to film?
I've kind of said it before. I think I would love to see Joe Mangle back. I'd love to see Fiona Cork back. I'd love to see Annie Jones back.
Yeah.
I was over the moon when they got Paul, who played Des Clark, to come back, because Paul and I are good mates still to this day.
They're all part of the real history of the show, aren't they? All those
and
characters.
That was hilarious when they got Darius to come back, because Darius, who played the original Scott Robinson before Jason, and he came back and he played Paul's henchman, which was just hilarious. We were having a great day that day. Jesse wants to know, what was it like to film the scenes where Paige and Terese were surprised by the SWAT team?
Well, the SWAT guys were really hot.
I was just going to say, did they come
in? Oh, I know.
Did they come in for music and they ripped their shirts off halfway through?
You should have seen us. It's outrageous. They were so good looking. Well, you couldn't see them, but their uniforms were just, oh my God. It does look good. Yeah.
Did you dream of the fireman over the shoulder and all that?
No. But when Scott McGregor puts on his police uniform.
I'm a straight male and he does it for me.
Yeah. We share a desk and we're in the green room and I'm just like,
Oh. He's such an ugly bugger.
Yeah. Horrid on the eyes. Yeah, look, it was a really full-on scene and quite surreal too. So, you know, because we're not used to sort of having that sort of thing go on in our nice little homey sets. So it was very bizarre, but
was it comic or?
Oh, God, no.
Oh, wasn't it?
No, it was serious.
Oh, okay. I vaguely remember the storyline.
No, it was serious. What evil plot would you like Paul to be involved in next?
Blowing up the world. I don't know.
Nazia asks that question.
Nazia. Thanks, Nazia. You're a good chick. I hope Nazia's a girl. What evil plot? Well, it's. And I'm kind of involved in. As I say, you know, I can't give anything away, but I'm involved in a very evil plot at the moment. Mm-hmm. I'm finding it a lot of fun. It's kind of sort of. It's taken Paul back about to where he was about 10 years ago. I don't know. I've just about done everything evil. The only thing I haven't done is blow up the world, take over the world, poison the world's water systems. But I don't know how I'd gain out of that.
Anyway, moving on.
There's a movie there. They did it in James Bond, bugger. Carl, he wants to know, what is the Limber Ladybird? Because he's never seen it in any book. Yeah.
Well, I'll leave that to your imagination, Carl. Could be anything you like. Damien and I have come up with a few suggestions. But we're still working on it. You know, it's a process. But keep watching because we have a new trick up our sleeves.
Oh, a new version of the Limber Ladybird or something completely different.
We have a new. No, it's not a version of the Ladybird. It's actually a new thing.
Because did you ever watch Ally McBeal?
No.
Ah, because I find, and anybody out there that remembers Ally McBeal, there was a...
I'm sorry.
But they had a similar thing.
In studio?
The Limber Ladybird.
Do you need me? Sorry. We're behind schedule. Stefan's talking.
The Limber Ladybird is like Ally McBeal's knee pit. Which the character of Richard used to always do the knee pit, and it used to send all the women absolutely gaga. And we never knew what the knee pit was.
Yeah. Oh, well, that's the idea. Yeah. It's great.
It's good.
Champion Bears of Sport asks, what did Paul do with Mannix? Or is that best not?
What do you think? Honestly, Mr. Sport for Bears, what do you think Paul did with Mannix? He's not in the picture anymore. And just the fact that when you saw that entrance, you know, Paul entered with a bolt of lightning, you know, that kind of says it all, really, doesn't it? I'm a little bit like the Limber Ladybird. I think that needs to be left to the imagination. And you know, you might never find out.
No.
Maybe one day when forensics digging up some rubbish dip somewhere.
Anyway, guys, thank you so much. That's all the questions that we have. Please tune in to our YouTube behind the videos and watch our Q&As and backstage videos.
Yeah.
See you guys.
It's been great.
Bye.
Hi to all the Kiwi fans out there. How are you going over the ditch? Now, as a true Kiwi, it's in our blood, it's in our DNA to beat the Australians. And I've just learned that there are a lot more Australian subscribers. So come on guys, get online and let's beat the Aussies.
Cut.
Okay, what's the next one?
UK.
Hello! Oh, how are you going there, chaps? Now, as you all know, my great-grandfather was English.